गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। स्टडी आई हैव एक्सप्लेन एक्सरसाइज 3C, सेल्फ प्रैक्टिस 3C। आई होप यू हैव डन इन योर कॉपी एंड यू हैव अंडरस्टूड ऑल थिंग्स। इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम यू कैन कॉन्टेक्ट मी एंड आई एम ट्राइंग एज सॉल्विंग मोर एंड मोर क्वेश्चंस एज पॉसिबल, बट आई होप ऑल्सो that you are also trying very well for theoretical test first and you are also revising some questions in your rough copy. So today I am going to start as expressing numbers as a sum of prime numbers. If any number is given, how can you denote as in prime numbers? Their sum can be prime numbers like that 9. Number is 9. You break 9 and take the sum of digit, means given number, it should be sum is the same, like this 9, sum must be prime numbers. You choose that number, if you take the sum of that number, so that number, given number, must be come. And that numbers must be prime numbers. How? See, 2 plus 7. 2 is also prime number, 7 is also prime number. If you add 7 to 9, it is also 9. So like this, you can represent. Next, if it is given as 13, you see 13, 7 plus 3 plus 3, 7 plus 3 plus 3, you can give, if you want to break 7, so you can write like this, 2 plus 5. 2 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3. This can be also written, but 3 is repeating. But in question, it is not given that don't repeat. It is not given. So you can use like this as to write. Like that, given 42. 42 number given, 42. So you can change this. I take sum 19 plus 23. See, 19 is also prime number, 23 is also prime number. So in both ways, 19 plus 23, it is 42. 19 is also prime number, 23 is also prime number. So you must break this 42 as in prime numbers and you take the sum of the numbers. So 19 plus 23, it is 42. Like this, you can do examples also. And next, to check whether a given number is prime number or not. If you want to check the given number is prime number or not, it is very simple way. I have to check the given number as prime number or not. To check whether the given number is prime number or not. Means given number is prime number or not. How can you check? Some examples also given. Example 10, it is given. Number is given 131. So for this, you choose that number. If you multiply the same number 2 times, the multiplication result must be more than 131 in such numbers. By this way, you can take that. So test divisibility by prime numbers less than or equal to the prime numbers whose square is near to the given number. The square is near to the given number. Near means not exact to, near to the square number result. As if we are taking 11, 11 is 10, 10 is 100, 11, 11 is. So after this, it is 121, 12, 12 is 144. This is more than 131. 12 into 12, you can take 12 into 10. So 12 into 10, it means it is 144. 144 is more than 131. So you can take the factors of 144 as less than 12. So you can take the prime numbers less than 12. Because 144 is more than 131, so you take the factors as prime number less than 12. So less than 12, you can write, take prime number less than 12, means take prime numbers less than 12, like 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11. That is 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11. You can take. By this way, you can have the good thinking as 131 is prime number or non number. So you take and find out by the divisibility by 2, see 131 by 2, it is not divisible because as int is not 0 or even number. By 3, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, sum is coming 5, it is also not divisible by 3, by 4 also not, by 5 also not, by 6 also not. By 3, by 5 also not, by 7 also not, by 11 also not. So all the prime numbers less than 12, you take less than 12, and by one, you examine if 131 is divisible by 2 or not, divisible by 3 or not, divisible by 5 or not, divisible by 7 or not. Is by 11 or not? If these numbers less than, these numbers, prime numbers less than 12, less than 12, if they not divide 131, it means the given number is prime. It means the given number is prime number. By the fact of divisibility, you can determine. So I have seen also by 2 it is not divisible, by 3 it is not divisible, by 5 also not divisible, by 7 also not divisible, by 11 it is not divisible. 131 is prime number. This is prime number. You can say this is prime number. Next, 287. 287. You can examine example 287. The number is given 200. Second question number is given 287. You take the number as you multiply the same number to same number. 11 equals 121, 12 equals 144. 13, 13 is 169, 14, 14 is 196, 15, 15 is 225, 16 is 256, so it is 287, 256 is very less than 287, you take 16, after that 16, 17 you take. 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 289. 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 17, 289 is less than greater than 287. So you take the prime numbers less than 17. You take the prime numbers less than 17. So 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. There are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11 and 13. 15 hours, 16 hours and 17. So less than 17. You have to choose less than 17. The prime numbers less than 17. All the prime numbers are less than 17. After that, you examine if 287 is divisible by 2 or not. This number is divisible by 3 or not. Again by 5, again by 7, again by 11, and again by 13. You check. If you find such prime numbers, divide any prime numbers, what I have written, that divide 287. So 287 is not prime number. This is composite number. So you try. By 2 it is not divisible, because 1's place is not 0 or 2 or even number. By 3, add this 8, 7, 15 and 2, 17. It is also not divisible by 3. By 5, last digit is not 0 or 5. By 7, see, by 7, 7, 4 is 28 and 7 is 7. So by 7, 287 is divisible. By 7, 287 is divisible. Again by 11, 11 on the 11, here 7 and 77. So you can see 11 to the 22 here 6 remaining. By 11 not divisible, by 13 also not divisible. But by 7 it is divisible. By 7, 287 is divisible. You can see 287 by 7. 7 puts the 28 and again 7 on the 7. So by 7 it is divisible. So 287 is not prime number. It is composite number. Means not prime number. It is not prime number. Next, I am explaining self-practice 3D. 3D. Attentively, you watch the video and try to understand the questions. If you feel any problem, you can contact me. I have told many times. See, self-practice 3D. Page number 60. First question, express each of the following as the sum of two prime numbers. Sum of two prime numbers, you should express this. First A, it is given 12. You express the sum of prime numbers. So 7 plus 5. 7 is also prime number, 5 is also prime number. B, 30. 30 means 11 plus 19. 11 plus 19. If you add 11 and 19, it is coming 30. The result is 30. 11 is also prime number. 19 is also prime number. In this way, question number C also you can do 68. 68 means 31 plus 37. 31 is also prime number, 47 is also prime number. 72, 31 plus 41. So you can write this. Question number 2, express each of the following numbers as the sum of the two odd primes. Means the number, sum of the numbers should be odd primes. Second A. Number is given 12. The sum must be odd prime. See, 7 plus 5. 7 is also odd number and prime number also. 5 is also odd number and prime number also. Both are odd number and prime number also. And B, you can see 30. So sum of the number should be odd number as prime number. So 13 plus 17. You see 13 plus 17. 30. 13 is also prime number and odd number also. 17 is also prime number and odd number also. In this way, you can do C also. 78 given. So 37 and 41. 37 is also prime number and odd number. 41 is also prime number and odd number. D, 90 given, 90. So 47 and 53. 47 and 53. So 47 is prime number also and odd number also, and 53 prime number as well as odd number also. In this way you can complete this question. Question number 3. Express each of the following numbers as the sum of the three odd prime numbers. Three odd prime numbers. You have to express in third question the sum of three odd prime numbers. Question number 3. Three odd prime numbers. It is given 3A. 15. So you represent the sum of the number as 15 odd prime numbers. So you can take 3 plus 7 plus 5. 3 plus 7 plus 5. 7 3 10 plus 5. So 3 odd prime numbers. 3 also odd number, prime number. 5 also odd number, prime number. 7 also odd number, prime number. In this way you can do. Question B. It is given 23. Number is given 23. So 23, it is given 5 plus 7 plus 11. 5 plus 7 plus 11. 5 is also odd number, prime number. 7 is also odd number, prime number. 11 is also odd number and prime number. So in this way you can do. Question number C. 45 means 5 plus 7 plus 13. 5 plus 7 plus 13. 23, sorry. 5 plus 7 plus 23. And D, 55 means 13 plus 19 plus 23. 13 plus 19 plus 23. Next, question number 4. Write 5 pairs of prime numbers less than 20 whose sum is divisible by 5. So you think 5 pairs of prime numbers less than 20 and sum is divisible by 5. Sum also is divisible by 5. So firstly you take the pair 2 and 3. 3 to 5. 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. So sum is divisible by 5. Second, you can take 3 plus 7. 3, 7. So 3 plus 7, 10. 10 is also divisible by 5. Third, 2 plus 13. You can take 2, 13. 2, 13. 13 to 15. 15 is also divisible by 5. And next, 3, 17. 3, 17. 17 and 3, 20. 20 is also divisible by 5. And so less than 20 should be less than 20. So write 5 pairs of prime numbers less than 20 and whose sum is usually 5. After this, you can see 13 and 17, last 1, 2, 3, 4, and last 5, 13 and 17. You can see 7, 3, 10, 0, 1 carry and 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 30. So this is all 30 is also divided by 5. In this way, you have 5 sets of the pairs that less than 20 and the numbers form of the prime numbers, pair of prime numbers divided by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 pairs. 1 minute. And next, question number 5. Check whether the following are prime numbers or not. So you can check 151. It is given 151. Prime number or not. So firstly you find, check 5, check 151 prime number or not. So how can you check? For this way, you take the numbers as square of the number that I have told already. If you are taking the less prime numbers as square of the number and you are examining the divisibility rule, if any prime number divide that number, it means that number is not prime number. And if any number not divide that number, it means that is prime number. So we take 151. As more than 10 you take, 10 times 100, 11 is 121, 12 times 144, 144 is less than 151, you take more than. And 13 is 169, you take 13 into 30. 13 is 169. 169 is more than 151. So you take the prime numbers less than 13. So 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11. Less than 13 you take the prime number. By this way you can examine 151 by 2. 151 is not visible because 1's place is not 0 or 2. By 3, 5, 4, 6, 1, 7. Some of the digit is not coming, 3 or multiple of 3. So by 3 also it is not visible. By 5, last digit is 1, not 0 or 5, so also it is not visible by 5. By 7 it is not visible. By 11 also it is not visible. So this number is prime number. 151 is prime number. So this is the answer. 151 is prime number. You can check according to this. After this, question number B, 69. So this is prime number. Means S. You can write also as S. It is prime number. S. 69. B, you see, 69. You take 5 as 25, 6 is 36, 7 is 49. 8 is 64, 9 and 81. So take 9 into 9. 81. 81 is more than 69. More than 69. You take the prime number less than 9. Like this, 2, 3, 5 and 7. By these numbers, prime numbers you take 69. If 69 is divisible by these numbers or not. By 2, not divisible. By 3, it is divisible. By 3, it is divisible. 3, 2 is 6, 3 is 9. By 5, it is not divisible. By 7, it is not divisible. So it is composite number. I told already, if any number divides this number, so that number will be composite number. This fact, so 9 is composite number, not prime number. Not prime number means no. Means not prime number.
not prime number. Next, the number 385 is product of three consecutive prime numbers. What are the three prime numbers? How can you get the prime numbers? See, question number 6. How can you decide 385 is prime number or not? So you decide this, how many? The number 385 is product of three consecutive prime numbers. What are the three prime numbers? So 385. Question number 6, it is given 385. So you know, as prime factorization in class 5th also you have studied prime factorization. You take the prime factorization of 385. Prime factorization. You can find out the prime factors. As you can try by the different numbers, by 5 it is visual. You can take, because last digit is 5, so by visual. See again, 5, 7 is the 35, 7. Again, 3 here and 5. Means here also 35. 35, 5, 7 is the 35. 77. Again, by 7 also. It is visual. 7 on the 7, 7 on the 7. By 11. By 11, 11 on the 11. At last one. So, it means 5, 7, 11. 385, the prime factors are 5 into 7 into 11. 5 into 7 into 11. 7, 5 ja 35, 11 ja 385. So in this way, you can get the prime factors, prime numbers that can, three consecutive prime numbers. What are the three consecutive prime numbers are? 5, 7 and 11. 5 into 7 into 11. 5, 7 and 11. It means 5 into 7 into 11, you can write. And last question 7, state true or false. If two numbers are co-primes, at least one of them must be prime. It is false, because it is not must be prime. If you take example 8 and 15, so 8 is not prime number. 15 is also not prime number. They are composite numbers. So this statement is not true. This is false. So for today's class, thank you, student. I hope you will complete the work timely.